28th of July 2014, heavy rainfall caused quite a lot of nuisance for the citizens of Amsterdam. Many streets were flooded and over 400 complaints were received on the official complaint line. It is interesting to note that during the storm, more flooding events were mentioned on Twitter than were reported through the official complaint line. This raised the question, would it be possible to measure rainfall using social media? In this video, I will be discussing the social weather app and the raindrop counter that are being developed so citizens can participate in scientific research. Using these tools, citizen scientists can contribute to measuring rainfall and flooding in urban areas. In the case of the heavy rainfall event on July 28, 2014, an overview of the flooding reports was made by combining the official complaints with messages on social media, such as Twitter and Facebook. This map clearly illustrates how citizens' reports can be used to determine the severity of flooding in an urban area. With this in mind, it was decided to design an application with which citizens can report weather conditions and flooding, the Social Weather App. The main purpose of this app is to collect information on the severity of rainfall and urban flooding. Let's have a look at how to use the Social Weather App. When opening the app, one sees the weather forecast and an overview of the current situation, as reported by other users. Most important, of course, is that the user can choose to report rainfall, cloud conditions in the atmosphere, wind, or flooding. In this example, we chose to report flooding. We decided to report flooding, so now we need to select a category of severity of flooding. In total, there are four categories of flooding to choose from. No flooding, for when a previous reported flooding has been resolved. Small flooding, for instance, when only one drain in a street is clogged. Moderate flooding, when there is water on the street, but it is still passable. And extensive flooding, when the water is no longer passable. In the report, a picture of the situation needs to be added as well. Lastly, the time and location of the observation need to be added, after which the report can be submitted. With applications like the Social Weather App, large amounts of data can be obtained at very low costs. Areas that often experience flooding can be located, giving a clear overview and making a comprehensive solution possible. The weather data can be used to fine-tune radar and other remote sensing technologies. However, since it is amateur sensing, large errors are part of the deal. Since the rainfall measuring is simplified to only six categories, the precision is reduced a lot. In addition, early experiments made clear that these were still too many categories for the user to differentiate between. It also proved difficult for citizens to stay committed and continue to actively use the app. With the lessons learned from this experiment, a new app is being developed with the city of Rotterdam as the testing ground. Apps are not the only promising source for data. Another option is to encourage citizens to place rainfall sensors in their gardens. This brings us to the raindrop counter, which is being developed by the Technical University of Delft. This device makes use of a piezo sensor, similar to the little sound chips you find in birthday cards. The sensor is placed in a small cylinder covered by a membrane, as shown in the pictures. When a raindrop falls on the membrane, a small voltage is generated by the sensor, which can be used to register the time intervals between droplets arriving at the sensor. Using some statistic theories, this can be used to determine the rainfall rate. With the help of citizen scientists, the raindrop counter can be placed at many locations in the city. It can measure local rainfall patterns that rainfall radars are typically unable to see. The device is relatively cheap and robust and uses little energy. The quality of the data obtained depends on the correct placement of the device. This is a large source of uncertainty, since installation will be done by citizen scientists themselves. However, by combining data from a large number of sensors, quality control algorithms can be used to check and correct data. Involving citizens in science can lead to a large increase in the amount of data available at low costs. To encourage citizens to participate, it is important to highlight the benefits of joining a measurement program. If flooding is registered regularly in their neighborhood, action to fix this can be taken much quicker and more efficiently. In this way, citizens can contribute to solving their own flooding problems. In addition, more ground measurements increase the quality of the weather forecast. So, now you have an idea how to involve citizen scientists in taking measurements and what the pros and cons are that you will need to take into account. And most important, a more accurate weather forecast means less chance of getting caught in the rain.